Engineer Tony Kavuma, the chief mechanical engineer and commissioner from the Ministry of Works and Transport, asked female truck drivers to go out of their comfort zone and apply for jobs to drive trucks and forklifters from the ministry.
Timekeeping, you know, endeavor to be timekeepers. And that's why I've told you that you'd rather be an hour early than a minute late. So you plan your journey as well, so that you're on time and you'll get, I can assure you, when you take this onto as one of your habits.
The chief executive officer, Ugandan National Oil Company, Proskovia Nabanja, urged the graduates to pursue their professional careers, and gender should not stop them from exercising their skills, since they are pioneers of other women who want to join the field. She also urged them to inspire other women to do the work which people think is for men, because working in a field that is dominated by men is wonderful, but it comes with challenges, but they are manageable once focused.
If it's about a job, let's go for it. If it's about a career, let's go for it. And she has gone for it. Because she has said, if the jobs are there, please open up the doors for us. Yes? So we shouldn't sit and wait for the opportunities to come. Let's go for it.
And by the end of the month, every 10 days you're paid. At the end of the month, you're getting some good money.
Meanwhile, leaders from Kamwenge District are worried about budget cuts, which have left many sectors underfunded. During the approval of a 31 billion 2023-2024 financial year budget, councillors asked district officials to ensure services are brought closer to the people.
Therefore, we need as council to see the performance of the previous budget, to see on local revenue we realize so much.
The councillors also expressed dissatisfaction and accountability for the previous budget.
But now they are asking that we give them time to show us what has been done in the past. I don't know if they are going to give us time to prove what is coming next.
Furthermore, Kalaki Women Entrepreneurs Circle has been launched for women in Kalaki District. The launch was presided over by the Deputy Executive of the National Women Council, Emily Akolu.
We are advocating for a man economy, you know, no longer that subsistence level, development. We want women involved in economic activities so that even when programs like SACOs are here, they are able to happily save, because the money is there. You can't save what you don't have.
Whereas some SACOs have had challenges on financial management, the SACO members were urged on financial discipline.
And every woman, whether you support a you or you don't support a you, is encouraged to be part of it. Already we have the women groups that have like 300 people, 200, 80, 100 women. Some of them don't even support me. But this is just to bring them together to see that they work as a team.
The women were told to keep their husbands in the loop of the activities in the circle, including money they borrow. Some of the women said the new circle would relieve them from borrowing from some commercial financial institutions that are very expensive. Report compiled by Sharon Nawasirie, Anthony Antwine, and Michael Onyinge for the news.